Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Catual, the Cyan scout ship. It's a very beautiful ship with a very interesting mechanic when going into landing mode. Isn't this cool? And back to flight mode. I talked about the Catual enough in my previous videos, just a very short summary. It has a huge cross-section from almost any attack vector, which is very bad, so it's very easy to hit. It doesn't have a lot of firepower and it has one of the worst cockpit views of all ships in Star Citizen. The only good thing about it is it's very agile, which isn't a bad thing, right? And we are starting with one the Swarm missile. Shields front side 72, stern at maximum. One the Storm missile. Shields front side 47, stern at maximum. And we are shooting now one SAS 3 missile. Shields front side 14, stern at maximum. And one SAS 4 missile on the way. Shields front side down, stern at maximum. I guess we are in a damaged state. And looks like we lost some engines, yep. Okay. And we lost a lot more. We lost the front end. I mean the front end when we are in landing mode. A lot of ships are losing wings and guns in 3.4 and didn't do this in any patch before. So the 3.4 patch is kind of the I'm losing my wings now patch. Let's see what we can still do. We still have our guns. And since 3.3 we don't have a speedometer anymore, so I have to guess. This looks like normal SM speed, and this looks like afterburner. This looks a bit sluggish to me, which isn't a big surprise, because we lost two of our four engine thrusters. Yeah, this is sluggish and not easy to control. Since 3.3 we lost our speed ladder. And when we were hit by one size 4 missile, we lost this part. This, I don't know how to call it, tail, bottom part, and we lost two engines. Let's do it one more time. One size 4 missile. Shields front side down, stun at maximum, and we lost this part again. And we lost two engines one more time. Yeah, this feels sluggish. Normal SM speed, I guess. I can't see it. And this looks like afterburner. But we are really drifting a lot. Yeah, this is sluggish, which isn't a big surprise because we lost two of our four engines and thrusters, I guess. And we are shooting two SAS-4 missiles now. By the way, this is what I meant by huge cross-section from almost any attack vector. I mean, it looks fabulous. that isn't a very good idea if you want to live, I guess. Firing. Torpedoes now. One, that's five torpedo. And as always, just for fun, one size nine torpedo. Auf Wiedersehen. I don't want to repeat myself over and over, so have those two memes, and I use missiles and torpedoes just as a yardstick. I have tested now 43 ships in 3.4.x. Where do I rank the Cartoal? Pretty much on the bottom of the list. The Cartoal only has two shimmers and the Cartoal doesn't have many structure hit points. So for now I rank the Cartoal tougher than the Prospector and not even as tough as the Herald or the Mustang Alpha or the Aurora MR. Let's take a look at the comparison. Blue is Cartoal in 3.2, yellow 3.3, and pink in 3.4. In 3.2, 1-size-4 missile was a mission kill. Nothing worked anymore, no guns, no engines. All I could do was to leave the ship. In 3.3, the Cartoal could take 1-size-4 missile with a red hull, but everything worked. And now in 3.4, 1-size-4 missile means that two engines are lost, the front and bottom part of the ship is lost, and the flight controls are very, very sluggish. Besides this, there isn't much of a difference between the patches. And we have the new section. Would I go into battle? Would I go into battle in a Cartoal if this game would be final? No way. The Cartoal has just too many disadvantages. She is a huge target from almost any attack vector. She is very fragile. The firepower is meh, and the cockpit view is just absolutely terrible. The only good thing about the Cartoal is she is very agile, but this isn't enough for me. By the way, the Cartoal is a Xian scout, but what's the role of a scout? So the ship doesn't even have a role yet. No, I would not take this Cartoal into battle. You can find a link to my spreadsheet and to Maloko's wonderful datasheets in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye! I decided to put this at the end of my toughness test videos from now on. If you already know this, then just skip it. So how tough is your ship? There are different factors, and I start with the hard factors. How many shield hit points does the shield generator provide? What armor does the ship have? Right now all ships only have some generic armor values. And how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? Then we have soft factors. How big is your ship? How many shield faces are hit by an attack? And how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing guns or wings. And then we have bugs. Right now we have a bug that the shields don't cover the whole shape of the ship, especially when the shape is elongated.